to one of our top stories now, and a federal court judge has found war veteran Ben Robert Smith murdered or was complicit in the murder of four unarmed Afghans. The decision comes after a defamation case was launched against Nine newspapers, which brought allegations of war crimes to light. One of the journalists involved was Nine's Nick McKenzie, and he joins us now. Nick, thanks so much for your time. It's been a big 24 hours for you, of course. You and Chris Masters covered this from 5 years ago. 110 days in court. It's taken a heavy toll, no doubt. How is this? How do you think this will ripple? This is significant, this finding.
Well, it's a massive finding. Obviously, the ball's now in the court of the Commonwealth authorities because this has been a civil process. The criminal justice system presumably will take its course. Where that goes, nobody knows, but that's a question I'm sure many Australians have, is what next in terms of potential criminal charges. Ben Robert Smith and his team, no doubt, are looking at the result. They flagged an appeal. It's another possible outcome. For me, though, the immediate sense is relief, not for us, but for the people within the SAS, and that's the majority of soldiers, who stood up and told the truth in the witness box, who stood up inside the regiment and confronted Ben Robert Smith because they knew what he did was wrong and they knew what he did was not about what Australian soldiers stand for.
And that's the thing, because you did have to rely on those SAS soldiers, didn't you, to come forward and tell what they witnessed in Afghanistan as well as the Afghan locals.
Our case would have absolutely failed if not for the men of the SAS coming to court and telling the truth. A very difficult thing to effectively blow the whistle in court. We have confidential sources who assisted us at times in our reporting, but to stand up for the truth against the Victoria Cross recipient, and not just a Victoria Cross recipient, but Ben Robert Smith has been exposed as a bully, as a liar, as somebody who intimidated witnesses or other guys in the SAS who fought alongside him and then stood up to him, intimidated them, threatened them. So to come up against him and to tell the truth and to expose these appalling war crimes was a huge thing.
Where does this leave the SAS? I mean, they have one of the toughest jobs in the world. You know, they're out there in active war zones having to react in the moment. Where does this leave them? I mean, does the Defence Force here have to take a really good hard look at itself?
Well, obviously there's been the Brereton report in November 2020, which exposed this significant war crime scandal. A lot of media reporting, etc. There's been significant reforms. This is a grim story. No one ever wanted to be here. We never wanted to go to court. Ben Robert Smith brought this case. But critically, what it tells us, it was the men of the SAS who exposed the wrongdoing. The moral core of the SAS is solid. We should be very proud of the SAS, and we remain so, because they stand for right, they stand for justice, and ultimately, without those SAS witnesses, Ben Robert Smith would have gotten away with his crimes.
And I guess there's a hope then they might be able to change the culture potentially.
The culture is changing, and there's a small rump of people, I'm sure, who are still backing Ben Robert Smith. But ultimately, you know, the guys in the SAS, what they told us, we don't fight like the Taliban. We fight fair, we fight tough, but we fight lawfully and justly. And the outcome is in exposing Ben Robert Smith for not doing that. It's a vindication of those many men, the vast majority of soldiers who do that.
And one of the key words we heard from you yesterday was justice. I mean, this was the biggest defamation trial that we've seen here in a century. The impact as well on journalism is significant.
Yeah, I mean, before we get to journalism, justice for those murdered. I mean, Ali Jan, he was the man, the Afghan man, kicked off a cliff. It's for some reason, Australians can sometimes struggle to feel the connection with somebody in Afghanistan a mile away. But he was a father with 5 or 6 kids. He was a husband. You know, his wife has no husband anymore. This is a man who was a civilian. He was detained. He was kicked off a cliff while handcuffed and executed. So some small justice for him. Of course, though, the criminal justice system will need to kick in before that takes place. Mm. For journalism, a huge relief. Investigative journalism can now continue doing its job. Had we lost this case, it would have been really difficult for investigative journalism. So it's a huge relief that journalists can report the truth and can fight. I mean, we wouldn't also be here if not for Nine spending a lot of money to fight this case in court. So thank God for that, and thank God that the truth won.
Do you think that... What does this mean going forward? I mean, it's such a challenging and complex case that we've heard over that 110 days, as we've said. What do you think this means, I guess, for the future of the SAS, of media, the scrutiny they're under?
Well, I mean, there's many things yet to play out here. As journalists, we'll continue to do our job, and we'll keep scrutinising the military where it fails, and keep praising those within the military who stand up for right, and that's the vast majority. There is much more to play out in respect of the investigations that are ongoing. The Office of Special Investigations has been set up by the former government. It was recently given a bigger budget allocation. Its job is to continue to investigate war crimes. We know Ben Robert Smith is its key suspect at the moment. The AFP is supporting the Office of the Special Investigations. The Commonwealth Director of Public Prosecutions will be analysing criminal briefs. It's a really grim, sad story in many respects, because we wish we were never here. Nobody wants to know of war crimes, but the more important thing is, if they occur, they are exposed and dealt with, and that's what's happening at the moment.
Yeah, a lot more to play out, Nick. Thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it. All right, Carl. Oh, and a special edition, rather, of 60 Minutes will go inside the Ben Robert Smith trial this Sunday night at 8:40 on 9 and 9 Now.